With all this flooding this spring and fall, it could have an impact on the spring of 2020. Meteorologist Grant Smith talks with a hydrologist to find out what forecasters are watching now.
A weather forecast many months ahead is near impossible because there's just too many variables that add up over time. But the flooding concerns might be worth talking about, and we have a hydrologist nearby who can shed some light on the matter.
At the Sioux Falls National Weather Service office, we find Mike Gillespie, the local weather service hydrologist. He's the guy who's been keeping a very close watch on these heavy rain events, and he's already put some thought into next spring.
If we can't dry those soils out some now, this fall, before we freeze up, then we are definitely looking at an increased chance of flooding come next spring.
That doesn't really sound good. Parts of Cal-Land really haven't had a break from the flooding since March.
Look at it as kind of a sponge. You put a dry sponge, freeze it, dump water on top of it, it's still going to soak up some of that water. You put a wet sponge in the freezer and freeze it, it's not going to hold any water. It's going to be like a block of concrete.
And that means water rushing through Cal-Land again. But the spring is still several months away, and there is still some time to recover and dry out these soils.
Normally, we don't see the soils freezing up really solidly until we get into November and December.
All that being said, there are still several reservations about making a forecast that far out. So it might be best to wait and see how the winter plays out before getting too worried.
By the time we start seeing that snowpack build up, we'll start getting a little better idea, say January into early February.
And Mike said that really any day that is warm, dry, and sunny is helpful in drying out the soil. So yes, at the present time, there is concern for flooding in the spring, but there is still lots of time to dry out before the ground freezes and the snow hasn't even started falling. So we have no idea what kind of snowpack we'll be dealing with.
So for now, it might be best just to focus on the immediate changes to our weather before the potential flooding in 6 to 7 months. For Cal-Land Weather, I'm meteorologist Grant Smith.